The New York Jets have informed veteran cornerback Trumaine Johnson that he will be cut before free agency, which is really no surprise. But the question now lies in how they will pay the $12 million he's owed. If a new NFL CBA is agreed upon before Saturday at midnight, the Jets can spread his salary over two seasons. But if the CBA is rejected, the team will carry $12 million in dead money in 2020. Time now to send it over to Dan Grasa and our panel. Now, Dan, after the Jets spent $34 million on Trumaine Johnson to play 17 games, where does he rank all-time on the Jets' worst free agent signings?
You mean that's not money well spent, Julie?
Is that what you're trying to say?
Is that where you're going there? No, it hasn't. It was not a good 2 years for Trumaine Johnson in the green and white when he was playing. He wasn't playing very well, and then you have the off the field. Just, it was a mistake, certainly, that this regime would like to move on past than they are going to here. Now, it doesn't hide the fact, guys, that they have to still find some help at the cornerback position.
Yes.
There have been a lot of free agent missteps over the years with the Jets. I'll give you one that maybe flies under the radar a little bit here. Guy who's going into the Hall of Fame this year, as a matter of fact, only played 1 year with the Jets. 1999, coming off the AFC Championship game, Steve Atwater, who Parcells signed from the Denver Broncos to play free safety. He barely played, and he looked every bit his age, and they sent him off into retirement. Not a good contract.
Okay, well, another guy who will go into the Hall of Fame, but this is obviously the worst signing, and it was Revis Part 2. I mean, yeah. How do you do $70 million in 5 years for a guy who admitted when he got here, I feel old. That is awful. It was terrible for Darrelle Revis here. You're paying a guy $39 million guaranteed for memories, Pete. It's no good.
I was so excited for Revis, too. That was the worst part of it. Like, I actually was sucked into it, and then he was not interested in tackling anybody for as long as he was with the Jets. But I'll go with Neil O'Donnell.
Oh.
He's coming off a Super Bowl appearance, quarterback, 5 years, $25 million.
Yeah, he made Larry Brown a lot of money that day, that's for sure. We never heard from him again after
didn't
that.
Didn't last long. Glenn Foley is taking over, and the savior before you know it, Neil O'Donnell. That one sticks.
Yeah, he and Parcells didn't see eye to eye. He only lasted a couple years, but then they moved on to bigger and better things here. But look, again, Jets still have to satisfy that cornerback position, whether that's going to be with some depth pieces in the draft. You know, there's a couple of guys in free agency, whether that's James Bradbury, Byron Jones, but I don't know if they're true number one lockdown corners to give those guys that money. They're not worth it.
Well, but think about it. I mean, you're just talking about getting out from under a high-priced free agent, and I think that Jones could be better than Trumaine Johnson, but you're still at the very top of the market there when the Jets have so many holes.
They do, and scheme is also a big issue there. Not exactly a great fit, though, but we'll see how they go and spend.